Very, very nice. You don't look vampire-y to me at all. Very kind of the opposite. Very alive and hello.
Thank you.
No, you look very well.
Thank you.
Yeah, no, that, this show is very sexy.
It is. It's very sexy and very raw, and I like it like that.
Yeah. Very, very happy you're here.
Thank you.
The vampires in the show, they're very attractive, though. I've never thought of vampires as being attractive until the current wave of them.
Yeah, it's sort of like the Baywatch of vampires.
It kind of is like a little bit, isn't it? It's kind of, but you're not a vampire yet. He's going to turn you into a vampire.
Yeah, I mean, that's sort of what he wanted to do, but I wasn't having it.
Oh.
Not at all.
Wow. How does he turn you into a vampire? Just bites your neck, sucks your blood, that's it? Usual?
They suck your blood, and then I think you have to, like, spend some time underground with them for, like, 3 days or a day. And then you wake up and you're really... sort of like that.
A little bit, yeah.
And then you wake up really hungry for blood. So, yeah.
No, I like when you do that. Hey, now, watch it. Where do they film this? It's not in New Orleans, is it?
No, it's actually here.
In Los Angeles?
We used to film some stuff in New Orleans, but now we're here, yeah.
I like New Orleans. You ever been down to New Orleans?
I have.
It's nice down there.
The food?
Very nice.
Amazing.
But you know that cafe they have in the square there? I can't remember. It's a very famous place where you can get the big knee and the you know.
Oh, the, yeah.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah, you know, it's the thing. And it's in
it's good.
Well, anyway, when I was there, there were a lot of birds came and pecked on my food. And...
What did you do?
I tried to shoo them away, but they were a little bit forceful. They were, you know, they were
right.
Crows, and they would come down and peck at my snacks.
And then,
did you ever get your snacks pecked when you were in a... It's a fair question.
Occasionally a peck or two.
Yeah, now, where are you from? Are you from L.A.?
I am from Las Vegas.
Las Vegas?
Yes. Oh. And you know a lot about Vegas, I hear.
Well, I've been there a couple of times. A couple of times I remember, a couple of times I don't, actually. Are you a gambler, or do you partake of any of the Vegas...
Nickel slots. Which, because I know it's all fixed and there's... Yeah.
No, it's not! What are you saying?
I mean, my family sort of is in that industry, and so I know
really?
A lot about it, yeah.
What are your family are in the mafia? Yeah. No. I meant...
I mean, they're, you know, they're...
They work in casinos?
Yeah.
Okay.
In the back.
In the back of the casino.
No, they're all in there in some kind of form or way, and I've always known that it's just... Gambling is just... Leave your...
I agree. I'm the same. I'm Scottish. It's like, so, you know, the idea that I give you the money and then you might give me some back, I'm like, no. What's in that for me? What's in that for me? Well, it might be more. Well, it might not. Yeah, so...
I mean, yeah.
Yeah, so no, I don't do that. But what do you do then for recreation in Vegas if you don't gamble? I presume you don't do...
Karaoke?
Karaoke.
I like a little bit of karaoke. I used to be a singing busser and a kind of like server, singing and dancing.
Which restaurant would this be?
It was Roxy's Diner in the Stratosphere.
Really? You worked in the Stratosphere?
Uh-huh.
Wow, did you ever go to Lovett's Custard? It's right across from
I've never been.
Oh, they
and
make
now
great,
I have to go.
No, you have to go. It's the greatest custard. I know that custard isn't that popular, but this stuff... It's kind of like ice cream, but it's frozen custard, and you know it's in a great neighborhood too. I think it's fine. It's just, you know, other people have mentioned that they thought the neighborhood was a little sketchy. I think it's fine. I think it's absolutely fine. You know, I've never had any problems there.
Look at that face, man. I don't trust you.
No. You don't trust me, and you're from Vegas? My God.
Oh, well, I mean, there you go.
No. What did you do in the Stratosphere then? You worked in Roxy's restaurant?
I worked in Roxy's as a singing busser and dancing busser, and then I also worked in the Stratosphere as an elevator operator. I used to take people up to the top.
Really?
Where the rides are.
Yeah, I've never been up there. Don't
go up there.
No, I...
Don't go up there.
Was it very vomity in that elevator?
You know what? No one actually ever vomited on me, but I remember... I'm afraid of heights, so it was actually...
That's a great job for someone who's afraid of heights.
Awesome.
Yeah.
And they made me get on the rides. Like, they were like, you're working here, so you have to get on the rides. And I was like, really? And so I was, scared for my life.
Yeah.
I'd never get on the rides again.
No, I don't like any of that.
Yeah, it was kind of rickety, and...
I'm sure it's perfectly safe for legal reasons.
But I mean, you're like 1,000 feet. What was it? 1,149 feet or something like that in the air. I mean, it's pretty high.
Yeah, no, so. You know what? If I'm there, I want to be, you know, someone giving me warm nuts. Yeah. In an airplane. So what do? You do the karaoke now here in Los Angeles?
Yeah, when I get a chance.
Really?
Uh huh.
No,
go over to like Brass Monkey over on Wilshire Boulevard.
Brass Monkey?
Brass,
it's a karaoke bar, Brass Monkey?
Mm-hmm. That funky monkey.
I've grown very fond of you over the last 5 months. We're actually out of time, so we have to. Yeah, I know you haven't been on the show before, so let me talk you through how we end this segment. You either have the choice of mouth organ, awkward pause, or a new addition recently, touch my glittery ball.
Well, being from Vegas, I think I'm gonna go for the glittery ball.
Really?
Yeah.
Okay. you have to wait until the phrase is said,
okay.
And then what I need you to do is then at that point choose how and... You'll figure it out. All right, are you ready? Mr. Bus Driver, touch my glittery ball! Please welcome the beautiful Rutina Wesley, everybody. Rutina Wesley. Rutina, you look sensational too. It's almost. Did you meet Jennifer backstage?
I did. Briefly.
Do you guys have a little pillow fight or something? Or?
Maybe.
Nah. Hey, this vampire show has gone crazy. This is the sexiest vampires ever, right? They're,
it's nuts. Yeah.
Is there more sexy vampire shenanigans going on this season?
More sexy vampire shenanigans, sex, raw.
Are you still talking or am I just hearing this voice?
I just said there's more sex. That's all.
Yeah. I just kind of went sex, raw, sex. Where are you from, Rutina?
Las Vegas.
Las Vegas. That's right. I remember now when you were here before because you don't gamble, right?
No, you know the nickel slots every now and then.
Yeah, that's not really.
But I know.
You know. But I guess if you live in Las Vegas, you're not really attracted to all that kind of thing.
Yeah, because, you know, I mean, it is a game. And, I mean, sometimes you win big and most of the time you lose big.
So I was just hearing sex.
Sex,
bro. Do you ever go out into the desert near Las Vegas and take some peyote and have a mysterious experience with your spirit guide?
A little bit.
But that's the thing about out there in the desert. I mean, you know, you get some powerful hallucinogens going there. It's awesome. I mean, terrible. I used to, but I don't anymore.
Okay.
Yeah, but, you know, back years and years ago, you know, in the 20s. Yeah. You look out a lot too, don't you?
A little bit.
A little bit, yeah. What do you do? Do you do the spinning?
No. Pilates.
You gotta be careful with that and make you crazy. Yeah, it does. No, it does.
How does it make you crazy?
Well, you know, remember, this is coming from someone who took a lot of hits of acid. But I think Pilates was developed by Joseph Pilates after the First World War, and it was developed as a physical therapy. It was not meant to be an exercise regime An exercise regime is a country where everyone is made to exercise.
Right. Right.
Right. It's not meant to be an exercise regimen for beautiful actresses. It'll make you crazy. That's the side effect of it.
Okay. I guess I should not do Pilates.
Well, you can do some, I suppose.
A little bit.
How much do you do?
You know, like three, four times a week.
That's too much.
Okay.
All right. So you maybe like once a week and then maybe do some yoga. Do you ever do the yoga?
I do some yoga, yeah.
Do you do the hot yoga?
Mm-mm.
Do you do the cold yoga? Just regular?
I do the raw yoga.
Oh,
I
bet you do, yeah.
Yeah. No, I do like a vinyasa flow yoga.
Whoa, hey, there you go. Ooh. Yeah, a vinyasa flow. That's like you do the downward dog. The, yeah. Yeah. What the hell's with the bookings right now? It's like, it's just beautiful women all the time. It's thanks, man. Do you feel competitive with other beautiful actresses? Is that a thing in Hollywood? Do you, like, when you see another beautiful actress doing well, do you think, ah, damn, I wish I was, you know, doing that?
No.
Come on.
No,
really?
I mean, you can't be. You have to feel pretty in your own skin. You also have to support, other beautiful women. And I think we should all support each other as women, you know? But I don't think it's good to be competitive. I think it's like a negative energy. I like to keep...
Have you been in this town long? Maybe.
Yeah, well, yeah, okay, long enough to know.
I think it's good to try and keep some kind of spiritual health. That's nice.
Right.
Yeah, okay, you're right. Now, where do you make the True Blood? Do you make it in L.A.?
No.
Where'd you make it?
Far, far away.
In Shrek?
No, it's here, and then we shoot some stuff in Louisiana as well.
Oh, see, now, yeah. I like Louisiana. You like it down there?
I like the food.
Yeah, the food's very nice. You got to do a lot of Pilates after you do some of that stuff.
Yeah.
Yeah. Do you ever go to New Orleans there?
I've been to New Orleans.
I like New Orleans, yeah. Do you have that powdery bread stuff they got there?
Is that the beignets?
Yeah. I was going to say it, but you do that with your fingers again. That's nice. So I'm married. Married?
Yes.
Yeah, good.
Me too.
Yeah. You seem to be handling it better than I am right now. It's a joke. I'm just kidding. Where did you meet your husband?
We met at school, actually.
You married your high school sweetheart?
No, Juilliard.
All right, so that's kind of college, right?
Yeah.
You met your college sweetheart?
Mm-hmm.
You married him. That's great. You were at Juilliard?
Mm-hmm.
Studying acting?
Yep.
And what was he studying?
Acting.
So he's an actor too?
Mm-hmm.
Do you guys, like, act out things? Like, do you pretend to be Barbara Walters and he pretends to be King Arthur or something like that?
Yeah. All the time.
Have you nice. Yeah. What do you fancy? A mouth organ, awkward pause, disco dancing, or, which is the new one, or do you want to go for the big cash prize?
Let's go for the big cash prize.
What time is it, Genesis?
It's time for the big cash prize!
50 American dollars in a bag with a dollar sign on it, just like the burglars use. In quarters, okay?
All right.
All right, 2 weeks to win. You can either answer a question or you can guess what's in my box. Here's how that works. I imagine a box in my head. But I don't know what's in it. Only Jeff knows what's in it. And you try and imagine what's in it. And then if you guess right, it's great and you win the money. And if you guess wrong...
Okay. Okay.
How do you want to do it?
Box.
Okay. I'm imagining a box, Jeff. Not for the first time tonight. Wait, Jeff, do you have the box?
Oh, yeah.
Okay, Rutina, what is in the box?
Ay, caramba!
Dancing?
Is that the NASCAR driver Dick Trickle dancing or a style of dancing?
Call right, okay.
Jeff, what is in the box?
We would have accepted 666 Raw, but it is.
Ay, caramba!
$50 American dollars, Rutina Wesley, everyone! see.
I did.
You're the first person that I've ever met in my life that's ever said, yeah, I actually like disco. Everyone else is like, oh, I was never into it. I'm like, really?
No, there's I really like it.
Yeah, okay.
I think there's something very saucy and perky about it.
Saucy and perky are definitely words in my head right now, but I don't know how you can... Oh, look, we're out of time. What do you fancy? Anyone?